Hi guys, happy Thursday. Hope y'all are doing good. I really, really, really hope you guys are doing okay throughout this whole thing. It's such a weird time. I'm making this video because I'm still getting emails and texts about this kind of same couple of questions. So I'm gonna do my best to answer them. Again, face to face. Okay. So question that I've been getting quite a bit is, is this graded? So lots of kids, when I say, hey, posted a new video or hey, uploaded stuff on Teams, I get an immediate email. Is this graded? Well, the short answer is no. So no, things right now are not traditionally graded. Meaning, if, I don't know, if Hunter doesn't do his work, then I'm not gonna go to the grade book and put a zero and make him fail algebra 2. We're not allowed to do that as of right now. Now, the information I'm giving you on this video is what I know right now at 4:37 p.m. on April 16th. Okay, so as of right this second, no, we're not grading you on assignments. So everything that I post is a suggestion, okay? Second question, which few of you are brave enough to ask me, but I know a lot of you are probably asking it in your head, is if it's not graded, why would I do it? And I totally, totally understand this question. And students aren't the only one asking it. So I get it. It's hard to want to do something when you're not gonna get anything in return. But let me flip your mindset a little bit, okay? What I want you to do is I want you to learn for the sake of learning. I want your reward for doing the work online. I want your reward to not be a grade. I want your reward to be a kind of a, oh my gosh, I understand this. That's good. You're gonna need that skill in life. You're not always gonna get something immediately in return for doing something, okay? And that's called intrinsic motivation. It's hard. It's hard to be motivated purely on your own instead of being wanting something in return for your work, okay? I need you to just be motivated in a sense of, I'm gonna learn because it's good for me, okay? Now, that might be a teacher thing for me to say, but the reason why I feel like I'm trying my best to give you guys some work to do is I'm concerned what's gonna happen next year as you guys are, you know, sophomores and juniors. I don't know what's gonna happen. We don't know what's happening still. We don't know if you're gonna just move on to Geometry 1. We don't know if you're gonna repeat Algebra 2. We don't know if we're gonna allow you to get credit somehow during this quarantine time. We're not sure. So I'm gonna do everything I can now to try and help you continue to learn, okay? That's my goal. I don't want you to just stop and play video games for 4, 5, 6 months and then just be a blob when you return to school, okay? So I'm gonna provide you with instruction little by little so that you kind of keep up the pace, all right? I'm really doing this to try and have you guys be successful, all right? So no, I'm not going through my list going, so-and-so hasn't done anything, I hate them. No, I'm not, because this is not my first priority either. All of our first priority right now needs to be our own health and the health and safety of our families, okay? That's gotta be the top thing on your list right now, all right? And then yes, if you are in a safe environment and you're healthy, people around you are supportive, then yeah, I want you to push yourself and I want you to do some math, all right? So speaking of that, I also want to just think about kids out there, students out there, who maybe haven't done anything the last month, because I know it's a good handful of you. So if you're a student who hasn't done anything the last month, or hardly anything, then you might want to really pay attention to this. Out of all the things, and here's what I mean by things, we got Khan Academy, we got Delta Math, we got Teams, and we got YouTube videos. It's a lot of stuff, right? I get it. So I'm going to talk through quickly, hopefully, of what the purpose is for each and everything. Okay, so Khan Academy. Most of you are signed up on Khan Academy by now. I had you to do that right before the closure, and that was kind of a band-aid. You know, Friday we were told we're not going to return until April 27th, and then it was like, how am I supposed to teach online? Like, I haven't been trained in this. So Khan Academy was a band-aid because I have used Khan Academy in my own learning. I just got done with my master's degree not too long ago, 2 years of online school, where you don't have a professor helping you face to face. You have to learn it on your own through reading it. When I get stuck on math, when I'm not understanding a concept, you know what I do? I go on a Khan Academy, I search up, you know, fractional exponents or whatever I'm stuck on, and I watch a video from somebody who really knows their stuff. So that's why I had you guys sign up on Khan Academy right now, okay? But I'm gonna kind of switch my whole thinking of do all this stuff on Khan Academy to, like, it's there when you need it, all right? I might be assigning new things on Khan Academy here and there, but I think the best thing you can do for yourself right now is to watch my YouTube videos, okay? The reason is because I'm the one doing them, so I'm really intentional about vocabulary and kind of the format of notes. So I recommend going onto YouTube, type in Meineke Math, and you're gonna see, I don't know how many videos I have in there, 8, 9, I don't know. But start with the oldest one. So it has the date that I posted it. Start with the oldest one and then work your way up to the current ones, the recent ones. Get out your spiral from class. If you don't have a spiral, find some paper, all right? And take some notes. You do learn better when you write it down so that you can, you know, physically practice doing it. But then also make sure you go over your notes. After the video, look over your notes and be like, do I actually understand this, all right? So video, best thing. If you're only gonna do one thing, watch the videos, okay? Second best thing you could do for yourself is to go on to Teams. Teams is located in my apps. Click on Teams, and then up pops your classes. Click my class, trimester 3. Click my class. And then on that main screen that you see, it's gonna be, there's top, middle-ish. There's like posts, there's files, there's something else, and then assignments. The files that I put on there are in the files tab. So you click files, and then it's gonna say class material, you click on that, and then it's gonna be week 1, week 2, week 3, week 4, okay? We're currently on week 4. So everything that I've done is in there. And there's only like, I don't know, 2 or 3 documents per file. It's not like I have a bajillion things being thrown at you, promise. Okay, so why I'm saying that is after you watch the YouTube videos, I would go into the files on there, and typically I have posted some sort of review activity in each thing. So like a worksheet, all right? So maybe open up that worksheet. Now, some of you are like, I don't have a printer, I can't do it. Nope, I have a printer, I'm looking at it right now. Guess what, it doesn't work. I have no idea why, but it's not printing. It's not like there's no ink on the paper when it comes out. I don't know why. So you know what I do? I pull up the worksheet on my computer and I get just, you know, a piece of paper and I practice the problems. Okay, so you practice problems. How do you know if you got it right? Well, I post answer keys. Literally, I'm giving you the answer. So remember, we're learning for the sake of learning. You're not learning to get a grade anymore. You're learning for the sake of learning. So what you need to do is do some problems And you can do the whole thing if you want, or you can do a couple, pull up the answer key and see if you're getting them right. See if you're on the right track. If you're not, maybe you need to go back to the video. Or you know what? Email me, text me, get some help from me, your favorite math teacher, right? Okay, so check your work using the answer keys. That's not something you have to send to me or take a picture, at least not right now, okay? That's more for you to know how you're doing. Remember, that's our focus now. We're shifting it from like, oh, I'm doing this to get an A, to, oh, I'm doing this so I can learn. Okay, bottom line. So YouTube videos, best thing. Second best thing is to go on to Teams and maybe do some practice, all right? And then some of you don't wanna do a worksheet and write it out. You'd rather go on Delta Math and just like type in the answer. That's fine. I have a few things on Delta Math. They're posted like 2 or 3 weeks ago, but they're still like, still try them if you haven't. It's on all the exponent rules. So Delta Math, we're familiar with that, so it maybe is easier for you to navigate. So do that. Do that, okay? If Khan Academy is like to you, then just put it away right now. That's fine, okay? So things are not graded as of right now. That could change. All right, I would love nothing more than to give you a credit, 0.5 credits for math, for actually completing some stuff. But let's say that in a week or two, this is pretend, by the way, this is pretend. Let's say in a week or two that, you know, PASCO has said like, hey, for the students who are showing they know their stuff, yeah, you can give them credit. Cool, I'll be happy to do that. But for me to feel comfortable giving you a credit, guess what? You have to do some work. You have to do some of the assignments and kind of show me that you're understanding the content. Now, I am not dumb in the sense that I know it's very easy to cheat because I'm not with you, right? So like, I'm posting a test tomorrow on Teams, on Exponents. I really hope all of you do it. Who's to say that you're not gonna take your phone and do photo math on it? I know about photo math. I'm not dumb, okay? Well, that's just kind of a waste of your time at that point. When you're taking your test tomorrow, I don't mind if you have your notes out. If you've been watching the YouTube videos and you have your notes out, whatever, okay? But really, that test that I'm posting is for you to see how you are doing. I want you to understand what you're missing in your learning, okay? Now, do I care about what you get? Yeah, I'm gonna look at it and I'm gonna look and see, oh, you know, Michelle needs a little bit of help on quotient rule, and then I'm gonna get with Michelle and then I'm gonna talk through it with her, okay? So we are learning for the sake of learning. This is to benefit you, and you gotta start thinking future-wise, your math track from here on out. You're no longer so concerned about getting an A, okay? You are more concerned of, am I actually understanding this, okay? But like I said, like priority, this is not your priority. Priority needs to be your health, your safety, your family's health, and your family's safety. That needs to be priority. So with that, I'm just gonna close out by saying, if you are struggling right now, if your family is struggling right now, please let me know if you can. You don't have to give me all the details, but let me know if you can, and if there is some way I can help, I would love nothing more than to help you, okay? I miss you guys, I do. I hope you see that. I hope you understand how much I wanna be in a normal classroom setting teaching, okay? I miss your faces, I miss you guys joking around and all that, okay? So take care of yourself, and if you can, I'd like you to do some math, all right? So there will be a test posted on Teams tomorrow. You can find it in the little assignments tab up there, but I'll send you a text and an email when that's all figured out. Probably around 9 or 10 a.m. tomorrow, I'll post it. Okay? I hope this was helpful. Yeah. See ya. Yay math. Miss you.